He's been doing the good works. So without further ado, he has just flown in. His wife was ill. He was worried, you know, he loves this woman. I don't know that I should leave. She said, you've got to go do this. He said, but you're sick. She said, you've got to go do this. This man is so selfless, so amazing, and he is here for you. This is Hollywood. This is what planet Earth looks to find out what are the international messages. So Gandhi has come to Hollywood, first time ever, to stand here in front of you today and energize you and give you permission to jump off the high dive into your life and create a better world. May I introduce Arun Gandhi.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I have come here to join you in this peace march so that we can bring peace in the world. And I have also come here to plant seeds of peace, because that's what my grandfather taught me when I was a little boy living with him. He said, when you grow up, you must go out and plant seeds of peace in the minds of people, and let those seeds germinate, and eventually we will have a peaceful world. So today we are marching not simply to end the war in Iraq, not simply to have peace in our country, but to create a new vision for our country. We have, over the years, created the vision of being a superpower in terms of our military strength. We now have to create the vision of being a superpower in terms of our moral strength. Yeah. And that we are as willing to do for ourselves that we are willing to do for the rest of the world. So we have to create that vision within ourselves. We have to become peaceful ourselves. Peace begins with us. That is why Grandfather said, we must become the change that we wish to see in the world. It has to begin with each one of us. So let us today take the pledge that we are not here to bring down a government. We are not here because we hate Bush, but we are here to create a new vision and to create that peace that would be meaningful for the rest of the world there. Let us rid ourselves today of all the anger and the hate and the prejudice and the discrimination and all of these negative things that we feel. Let us replace that with positive thinking, positive attitudes, love, respect, and understanding of each other and of all of humanity. So if we take that pledge and begin to change, we will bring peace all over the world within our lifetime. I thank you again for being here today, for joining in this parade, and I hope that many more thousands and thousands of people would join and all over the country to make our voice for peace heard everywhere. Thank you.
In just a few moments, Mr. Gandhi is going to step into a pan of plaster of Paris, much like the Hollywood Walk of Fame around you with all the different stars or groundlings where the movie star footprints are planted. He's going to step into plaster of Paris, and it's going to be the first step for world peace. Yeah. And because of you, this has turned into a worldwide movement. Japan has signed on, Italy, Spain. We're going to be traveling around and carrying these first footsteps for peace. A lot of different Hollywood people have shown up at their own professional peril. Not everybody is going to really appreciate that they stand for peace when a lot of the mechanism is for war. And I'm just going to give you the quick backstory of how Mr. Gandhi came to play in this. Last June, it was the gay rights parade, and I was doing commentary for it, and they said, don't get political, because it'll offend somebody. And the day before, Congress was poised to write this entire group of people out of the Constitution. And I thought, well, but don't offend anybody. And they said, talk about the sponsors. And I looked around and it was ID Lube and all this other stuff. And I realized this group had been reduced to intercourse jellies in American Airlines. There had to be more. So I went on my radio station on KTLK and I said, we need to have a proper civil rights parade. Gays plus one, bring your own oppressed minority. And it was set there. And so Mr. Gandhi on 9/11, we thought after hearing four-star generals on all the different shows saying blow them up, there had to be something different. And this man stood for peace and love and unity. And here you are today, and this sets it off, the March for World Peace, because of you. Thank you.